Hi everyone, so previously we looked at insertion sort. Now in this DSA playlist we'll be looking at selection sort. We'll be going through the algorithm with example, of course. We'll be analyzing using time complexity. We'll be drawing out the advantages and disadvantages of this particular sorting technique, which is selection sort. Okay, so selection sort is basically an algorithm which is an in-place comparison based algorithm. Over here, the list is divided into two parts. The sorted part is placed at the left end and the unsorted part is placed at the right end. Initially, the sorted part is empty, so we take the unsorted part as the whole array. So let's say we have array of 6 elements. The whole array would be considered as the unsorted part. So we start by traversing through the array and finding the smallest element within the array. So let's say we have 6 elements and we find out the smallest element is at index 5. So we replace that element at index 5 with the first position. And that first position becomes the sorted list. After we have a sorted list at the left hand side, we'll only traverse the array from the second position to the end position. So total elements we'll be traversing in the second attempt would be only 5. Now out of those 5 elements, we'll be finding out the smallest element. We'll be swapping the smallest element with the second position and then we'll continue and we'll traverse through the array only from the third position to the last position, which in this case would be the 6th position. And this process continues, moving the unsorted array and making it sorted each time we pass the element. Each time we find out the smallest element, we replace it with the first element or the second element or whichever the element is present. So over here you can see two lists created. First list is the left hand side, which is the basically sorted list of elements, and we have a list at the right hand side over in which we are searching of the smallest element. Now we'll look through an example over here. So firstly, for each index position we are considering it as I. So I is the first position. We traverse the array to length minus 1. Now why length minus 1 is taking, I'll be explaining in the code. So we'll find the smallest data value in the array from position I through the length minus 1. And we'll exchange the smallest element with the value at position I, which would be initially the first position. Then after it's sorted, then it would be the second. Then similarly, it would keep increasing by 1. Okay, so these are the steps involved of actually doing the algorithm. Now, many ways the code can be done, but these are the particular steps that we'll be inculcating in our code. So step one is setting the minimum location to 0, then searching the minimum element in the list or the array, then swapping the minimum element with the location min. Then we'll increment the value of min to the next element, and we'll do the steps until the list is completely sorted. Okay, so here we have an example of an unsorted array or unsorted list, 5, 2, 1, 4, 3. So firstly, what we'll do is we know how selection sort works at the very gist over here. We have two lists at the left and the right. So firstly, the whole list would be considered as unsorted. We'll find the smallest element within this list, which in this case would be 1. We'll swap 1 and 5, that would be our first iteration. Second iteration, as 2 is already over there, so we don't need to swap it. So that would be the second iteration. It would go unchanged as 2 is already over there. Then we will look into elements from 5, 4 and 3. In 5, 4 and 3, we can find that 3 is the lowest. So we'll swap 3 with 5. We'll swap 3 with 5 and then we'll only check 4 and 5, which again would be unswapped because they are already in position. We'll look to one more example. Over here it has again 6 elements, but the numbers are quite easy to understand this time. So over here we have 6 elements and we have the smallest element, which is 8 over here. So we'll firstly swap 8 with the first position, then we have 5 left, then we'll run the array, we'll traverse the array from 78 to 56, we'll find the smallest. So over here the 23 is the smallest, so we'll swap 23 with 78. We'll keep continuing this till it reaches a complete sorted array, till it becomes a complete sorted array. Now you can notice one thing over here, that we have 6 elements and we'll have 5 steps. So this would be a thing that we need to remember in code. When we have the number of elements as 12 or 13, we'll have 6, 13 minus 1, which would be 12 passes. And when we have 6 elements, we'll have 5 passes. Okay, so coming to time complexity in big O notation. So the best case performance would be O n squared. Similar would be the average case and the worst case performance. Now we'll be drawing out conclusions from this kind of time complexity in the advantages and disadvantages. So the main advantage of the selection sort is that it performs really well on a small list. Now that becomes a disadvantage as well when the list is larger, because if the list is larger, the efficiency decreases as the number of steps involved in selection sort are too many. So that's the main advantage, but in a small list, and that's a disadvantage in a bigger list. Second advantage is that no additional temporary storage is required. And the disadvantage on the other side would be it requires n squared number of steps for sorting n elements, which I already told you guys, the number of steps involved is too much compared to other sorting elements. Okay, now we'll go through the code. Okay, so over here we'll be firstly going through accepting an array, inputting an array from the user. So we'll input an array from the user firstly. For the noise, guys, it's a mechanical keyboard. Let's set an array. We need to know just one thing, that is sorting the smallest element with the first element. That's the only thing that we need to remember in this particular sorting technique. Okay, so here we have inputted an array from the user. So after this, we'll be running two for loops. One for loop would be to check the element, whether it's the smallest element or not. And the second for loop would be for the right side that we initially told you guys. So first for loop would be to save on the left side, that it starts from 0 to, let's say, the end of the array. And the second for loop would start from the position which has already been saved. So let's say the first iteration has already been done, so the second iteration needs to be checked. So that would be the second condition over here. So we'll be writing the code for it. First for loop contains I equal to 0. I is less than n minus 1. For n minus 1, as I told you guys, the number of iterations would be less than the number of elements entered by the user. Would be 1 less. And then we'll go across the array. Now after this for loop, we need another for loop. This for loop would be for using j and comparing j with I. So we'll input j over here, and basically j will be 1 greater than I. So j's value would be always 1 greater than the left element that we have sorted. So j is I plus 1. J would be therefore less than n, and therefore in j plus plus. After this for loop, we need to compare that the value of the element i is equal to the value of element j or not. So for that we'll be using an if statement. We'll be doing if array of element j is less than array of element I. So for that, So if this case happens that j is less than I, then we what will we do? We swap the element. So basically j list is the smallest element that we are going through, and then we swap the element of at j at the first position or the second position, whichever the position I is. So not a semicolon. So basically after this if statement we'll swap it. For swapping it, we can directly swap it. We need to create a temporary variable, which we have done in basic programs like palindrome and all those programs. So we'll create a temporary variable, and we'll store the value of j element in that. We'll swap the value of j with I. Basically this condition is denoting that the second element or the third element is the smallest element, and we'll be swapping the smallest element with the first element. And here the swapping has been done. Final step would be storing the value of I into temp. This basically would be storing the value of I into temp, and this whole if statement would be taking into account whether it's the smallest element or not. And if it's the smallest element, it would be swapping it with the first element or whichever the element at position I. Okay, so after this, just before the main loop, we need to over here we'll go through another for statement just to print the array. So we'll be printing the array using int I equal to 0, I is less than n, and then I plus plus. And we'll have to print it. So we'll use a cout statement for it. Cout array I. And then we also need spaces between arrays. Giving space as well, and then we can run it. Okay, so number of elements I'll give initially as 5, and then the elements, let's say the elements are 43 space 56 space 89 space 24 space. So here, as you can see, the code has been executed and the selection sort works. Remember, selection sort is good for sorting small lists and not long lists, as the number of steps involved are a lot. But again, going through the code, firstly we input an array, then we run the code using two for loops. The first for loop is for iterating the I position, which over here we can call as the first position, and it keeps changing as the smallest element has been sorted. And the j position for loop is for basically checking which is the smallest element, and if we find the smallest element, then we come to the if statement and it gets swapped. Now for swapping, we cannot directly swap it, we need to store it in a temporary variable, hence we use temp, and after which we just print the array. Thank you for watching this video, and hope you watch the whole playlist. Thanks a lot.